Hey people, it is Katie here coming to you from the Project Me 30-day challenge, PH360 house here in Mexico. And I was just sitting here in this hot and humid environment with the AC going and the fan going here. And it just really inspired me to share with you about a learning curve that we are currently in the midst of here at the Project Me PH360 houses here in Mexico, because it's all about being totally real and totally honest. And I think this is a really fascinating learning curve that we're going through. So as you guys know, this is the first time ever PH360 has brought together people with different body types from all over the world to put them in this like incubator, working hub, shared working living space all together to live in everyone's own flow. So honoring our own chronobiology, which is looking at the body's natural rhythms, circadian rhythms, all of that, and what tasks and what time of day is most appropriate for each one of the health types or the body types that's in the PH360 wheel. So we have a representation of every single body type there is out there. We've got some of the long and lean peeps. We've got some of the strong and sturdy peeps, and we've got some of the energetic go, 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 go peeps. So we've got a really interesting smattering of everyone all across the wheel. And I mentioned this before, but it's really fascinating what we're dealing with here right now is just how important the climate is for operational efficiency and balance for every different body type's systems. No matter what body type you are, there is an ideal climate where you operate most efficiently. Now, we are here in Mexico right now in the middle of summer where it is very hot and very humid. And this type of environment is perfect for the ectomorphs, those long and lean individuals who are okay with just having sweat pour off their body and they don't mind being all sticky and glistening. And we're also living with endomorphs and mesos who are a little bit more sensitive to the humidity and can easily overheat their own body because internally their bodies generate a lot of heat naturally, whereas the ectomorphs, their bodies don't retain as much internal body heat as some of the thicker bodily structures are that have a thicker fat tissue and thicker muscle and bone structure as well. And so it's been really fascinating trying to accommodate all of the different health and body type needs in this humid environment, as well as honoring everyone's chronobiology. And I'm not gonna lie, like we haven't perfected it. This is why we're here. This is like a learning curve of the first time we're doing something like this to see how all of the body types can come together in a space and work. But also, you know, looking at the other environmental factors that's going to influence the space as well, like the weather. Like we can't change the weather wherever we are. Sure, we can be indoors or outdoors, and we've got things like AC and furnaces. But to live with the least amount of resources and footprints that we're going to draw, environmental footprint that we're going to have on the space that we are at, you know, how do we all live together and work together in a harmonious way that's going to honor all of our different flow times? And so it has been a real learning curve to come up with a plan on how we're going to honor all of the different climate needs from all the different body types, as well as honor everyone's chronobiology. So like, for example, the ectomorphs, their most productive time of day is first thing in the morning. And so in the shared common spaces, they want it to be nice and warm and humid because that's the environment that their body thrives in. So they want the common space to be warm and humid in the morning because that's when they're at their most productive time. However, we also have some mesomorph body types who are here who also have their most productive time in the morning, and endomorphs have their most productive time in the morning, but they need the environment to be cool and dry for them to be most productive. And we only have certain areas that is a shared space that has like desk office facilities for us to actually utilize. So how do we make that work? So, you know, it has been a lot of negotiation and a lot of back and forth, hearing everyone out, honoring that everyone has completely valid needs and how we're going to make that work. And I'm actually really quite proud of how we have tackled this, because we had an experiment where we tried to go no AC for a week and see if we could maximize the natural cooling cycles of the day and see if we could find some hours of chronobiology that would fit into those times of day. Didn't really work. So that's okay. We tried it out for a week and then moved on. And so the other day we had a meeting where we brought in everyone who was in the space who was going to be affected and had a roundtable conversation. Everyone talked about, you know, their experiences, what they were feeling, and what their needs are. We regrouped, we looked at our chronobiology and our flow, and we came to an agreement on times of day and alternating the times of day throughout the week so that we could honor everyone's own chronobiology and their productivity times every single day. So we've been testing that out to see how it goes. And so why am I sharing this all right now? Well, a couple of reasons why is, A, this is the first time that PH360 is doing this, and we're learning just as much as all of you guys out there who are watching us are learning. And, you know, I'm all about being authentic and transparent, and I'm totally cool with sharing a lot of these learning curves that we're going through. And I think that it's also really important for everyone to understand just how important climate is to our bodies, and for everybody to be able to operate at their maximum potential, and how to balance out and how to negotiate and manage two different body types, or three, four, five, six, however many body types working in the same space. How can you make that work so that everyone can work together and get their needs met? Because climate has such an impact on our body and our optimum health and our balanced physiology. So it really is something that I don't think a lot of us really take into account when we are thinking about our own needs, our space needs, place needs, home, work, office, vacations, where we're going to take vacations, you know, really factoring into account the climate and what's going to be most ideal for our body so that we can have a true experience, be it a relaxation experience when we're going on vacation. You want to make sure you're choosing the right environment and right kind of climate for your body. And that's what PH360 really brings to the table with their awesome platform that they have, as well as the chronobiology tool, is just to truly understand what is going to be best for you. So this is all learning curves. We're working through it. We're bringing you guys along for the ride. And I just wanted to share another update as I'm kind of starting to glisten here. I need to make sure I get the AC on a little bit stronger, because I'm starting to feel a little hot and toasty. So I hope you guys are having a beautiful day. Talk to you again soon. Bye.